to understand all the models in a short, in an abstract. Okay, so we'll see the first model. In first life cycle model is a build and fix. So what is done in build and fix? You have to buy the house. I have given the example. That is, I have to build a house. Okay. Now, what are the strengths of this model? Build and fix model. So this model is fine or suitable for short programs or short projects that will not require any maintenance. Okay. So for such a short projects or programs or product, the build and fix model is suitable, because in build and fix model we are not seeing the actual needs of the clients. Next, what is the weakness of this build and fix model? So it is totally unsatisfactory for non-trivial programs. Why it is unsatisfactory? Because let you want a mobile, and I have given you a mobile of Nokia, that is a conventional Nokia, which have no Android applications. So are you satisfied with that kind of product? No. Okay. So that is what the example of build and fix model. Second life cycle model is a waterfall model. So this is also very important and well organized model. Why this is well organized model? Because it is a discipline approach. It having a discipline approach. Everything is on paper. So that's why it having a document driven. That means everything is put on a document. Okay, so you have clear cut plan of each and everything or each and every steps. Okay, so it's highly disciplined approach. You cannot, so that is what the disadvantage, that is delivered product may not meet client's needs. Okay, I have followed the certain needs of the your client, but after building my product, I hand over that product to the client. So that time client may not be satisfied with this product. So that is what the disadvantage of waterfall model. That is, after completion of all the phases, you can hand over your product to the client. So that is what the weakness or disadvantage of the waterfall model. Then you have the rapid prototype model. Now it will ensure that delivered product meets client's needs. Okay, in rapid prototype model, we are giving the product in the initial phase itself to the customer or to the clients. Okay, so that is what the advantage. Now what is the disadvantage? Not yet proven beyond all doubts. Okay, that means still this type of model is not 100% proven. Okay, that means it will satisfy all the needs of clients. Okay, so we cannot say that. So that is the weakness. Fourth model is a incremental model. So in incremental model, we have seen in incremental model, we will purchase the house. Okay, and then we will modify our house according to our needs. So that we have seen. Okay. Is it audible to all? Only 15 students are there. So not all, only 15. I think so. Okay. So what is the incremental model? It will maximize early return on investment and promotes maintainability. Okay. So here you have to buy the house and you have to do the modification into your house. So that is what the strength. Now what is the weakness? It requires open architecture. Okay. And may degenerate into build and fix type of modules. Okay. So that is what the disadvantage with the incremental model. Now fifth model is a V-shaped model that we have seen. What is the V-shaped model? We incorporate testing at each phase. That is what the state. That means in each phase we are going to test our needs or our objectives. What is the weakness of the V-shaped model? Usable product will be delivered very late. Okay, so just see, if you take a time to design and test each and every phase, so rather than 1 year, it may take 2 years, because you are doing the testing in each and every phase, and that will increase the overall completion time of your product. So that is what the weakness. Now the last one, that is a spiral model. Now what is the new spiral model? It will accumulate or incorporate all that is features or advantages of all the models. So it will try to acquire the advantages from all the models, that is waterfall model, rapid prototype model, and it will support the risk analysis facilities. So that is what the biggest advantage of spiral model. Now what is the weakness of this one? That is, it can be used only for large scale in-house products, and very importantly, developers have to be competent in risk analysis and risk resolution. Okay, so very important disadvantage of spiral model is your developers should be expertise in risk analysis. Okay, and that is very difficult task basically. And another difficult task is to retain such a developers for a long time. Otherwise, before completion of your product, your developer may switch from switch to another company. Okay, so that are the risk while using the spiral model. But you can use it for large scale products. That is what the advantage. So this is all about the different models of your different life cycle models or your embedded systems. Okay, so even if you have not understood it completely, but with the help of this particular table, you can understand the model. Okay, so in this you have to just understood the basic idea implemented in each life cycle, like what is build and fix, what is waterfall model, what is rapid prototype model, what is incremental model, what are its strengths and weaknesses, along with you have to draw the diagram of each model. Okay, so I have invested 3 lectures because in the exam there is a question on this particular point. Okay, definitely they will ask a question on the these points. Okay, very favorite questions, that is waterfall model, rapid prototype model, and spiral model. So these are very favorite models for the theory papers. Okay, so I think I will stop here. If you have any questions regarding this, you can put. Okay, Samiksha, this will have one. Please share the recording on Google Classroom, remaining all up to today. Okay, so whatever the recording I have, I will share it on Google Scholar, or otherwise you can go to my channel directly, Dr. Yuvraj Kutai on YouTube. I will upload all the lectures, whatever lectures I have recorded. Maybe some of the lectures I have not recorded, I have not remembered to record. Okay, any other questions? Any other questions? Yes, no. Otherwise, thank you.
No, sir.
Okay, no problem. Maybe next time, next topics are very interesting. This is very theoretical topics. But since it is theoretical, I have explained it for 3 lectures. Okay, then we will stop here. Okay, on Monday we will start with a new topic. Okay, that is very interesting topic. That is development phases we have seen. Okay, but we will see that different development tools. Okay, so those tools already you have seen in the system programming and operating system. So we will see some revision from this. Tools. Also, we will see what is IDE. Okay, most of the time in the oral and also in the interview, when you go for interview in industry, definitely they will ask you this question. Okay, that is, what is IDE? Okay, this question is a very favorite questions of all the industry persons. Okay, what is IDE? Integrated development environment is okay, and what are the development environment? So we'll see this, all these details. Okay, what is cross assemblers? Okay, we'll see the cycles likewise. So this is very interesting point. Okay, I think we'll stop here. Okay, thank you very much, and again. congratulations to all the successful students.